Hello everyone, do you know Jibananda Das, a Bengali poet whose poem is Go Where You Will? Go Where You Will is a heart-wrenching poem which depicts Jibananda Das' love for his native land, Bengal. He is highly depressed by the partition of his land by the Britisher. He was born in Barisal, which became a part of East Pakistan. When India was divided into India and Pakistan, then Barisal was supposed to become a part of the newly formed country of Pakistan. It was then time when millions and millions of people had to leave their city of birth and adapt a new city. Same was the case with Jibananda Das' family, a fact which is not acceptable to him. So in this poem, he reflects his pain in agony. In the poem, Das is describing about the beauty of Bengal with a sense of melancholy because he's feeling very dejected due to the bifurcation of Bengal, a thing which is unbelievable for him. We can see his desperation from the opening line till the end. In the first paragraph, it seems that he is addressing some people and saying, wherever you want to go, you can go, but I will always remain to the Bengal shore and will see the beautiful scene at the dawn when, due to slow breeze, the leaves of the jackfruit tree will be dropping on the ground. In the evening, I shall see the beautiful Charlotte bird when it will spread its wing, brown wing and its yellow leg under the white dawn goes on dancing in the grass when there is still darkness. And then suddenly, oak tree standing in the forest will wave Charlotte to sit on its heart side. I will see the feminine hand wearing the white conch bangle who is crying like a conch shell in the ash grey when white standing on the pond side in the evening. Das is imagining as if the lady will take the parched rice used duck, which is very popular in Bengal, to some other places where legends live. The poet is highly impressed by her beauty and believes that the sweet fragrance is clinging to her body, which is very attractive. She seems to be so fresh and pure as if she was born in the water cress in the pond's nest. Her feet are so beautiful as if the water of the river washes her feet every day, silently, and then goes so far that it becomes traceless in the fog. Regarding the present condition where there are so many crowds on the earth, still poet is sure that he will not lose his lady love because she is there on the Bengal shore. This optimistic note is a fine example of true love of poet toward his lady love. But there is a true love for one's motherland also in this poem.